Sunday, the 29th of April 2018, 12:21 p.m. Press release, UNFCCC governments meet in Bonn to step up climate action critical to the implementation of Paris Agreement. Bonn, the 28th of April 2018 governments are meeting for the next round of UN climate change negotiations from the 30th of April to the 10th of May to further develop the guidelines for implementing the landmark 2015 Paris Climate Change Agreement. This will allow the agreement to become operational. The guidelines, or operating manual, are needed to unlock practical actions to realize the full potential of the agreement. The final decisions are to be taken at the UN Climate Change Conference, COP24, in Poland at the end of this year. Finalizing the Paris Agreement guidelines is also necessary to assess whether the world is on track to achieve the agreement's goals, to limit the global temperature increase to well below 2 degrees Celsius, while pursuing efforts to limit it to 1.5 degrees Celsius. To reach success at COP24, it is essential that nations begin working towards draft negotiating texts at the May meeting. This will provide a solid foundation for work in the second half of 2018 and help them to deliver a strong result, said Ms. Patricia Espinoza, Executive Secretary of UN Climate Change. At the UN Climate Change Conference, COP23, held last November under the leadership of Fiji, nations agreed to accelerate and complete their work to put in place the guidelines, officially termed the Paris Agreement Work Program, PAWP, at COP24 in Katowice, Poland in December. The Talanoa Dialogue. Another important objective of the May session is holding the Talanoa Dialogue. This dialogue will facilitate the engagement of countries and a range of stakeholders in a vital international conversation around ambition now and in the future. The Fiji-led Talanoa Dialogue is facilitated by the UN Climate Change Secretariat and will benefit from the presence of high-level officials from Fiji, including the Prime Minister, who is the president of COP23. The consultative dialogue will check progress, reaffirm the goals of the Paris Agreement and aim to find solutions to how countries can increase their ambition now and in the next round of their national climate action plans, officially termed nationally determined contributions. As per tradition in the Pacific region, the goal of Talanoa is to share stories and define solutions for the common good. Similarly, in the context of the international climate change process, the Talanoa Dialogue will invite participants to share stories to find solutions for the global common good. 2017 witnessed many extreme weather events and disasters that caused suffering for millions of people around the world. The consequences of climate change impacts are already being felt, particularly by the most vulnerable communities, said UN Climate Chief Ms. Espinoza. The Talanoa Dialogue is a key opportunity for all stakeholders to come together and share stories on how we can significantly step up climate action to prevent even greater human suffering in the future. I encourage widespread participation in the dialogue, she stated. This first phase of the Fiji-led dialogue will write history when countries and non-party stakeholders, including cities, businesses, investors, and regions, engage in interactive storytelling around current and future ambition for the first time on the 6th of May. The output from these storytelling conversations will feed into the Talanoa Dialogue's political phase at COP24. The political phase will bring together ministers and high-level government officials for conversations with a view to generating political momentum. Ambition before 2020. Throughout 2018, countries will also focus on how they can scale up their climate ambition and implementation in the pre-2020 period. All countries share the view that climate action prior to 2020 is essential. COP24 will hold an event to take stock of the pre-2020 efforts. Earlier this year, Prime Minister Frank Bainimarama of Fiji, President of COP23, and Ms. Espinoza urged countries that are yet to do so to ratify the amendment containing the second commitment period of the Kyoto Protocol. The Doha Amendment sets out emission reduction commitments for the period 2012 to 2020 for many developed countries. The amendment has been ratified by 111 countries and will enter into force after it is ratified by just over 30 more. Concerned about the need to accelerate action, Ms. Espinoza said, "I strongly urge developed countries to make progress towards mobilizing the $100 billion United States dollars that they have pledged to provide per year by 2020. Many developing countries desperately need this support in order to make their contribution to climate action." Opening press conference on Monday, the 30th of April at 13:15, CEST, Executive Secretary Espinoza will be giving an opening press conference in Room Nairobi 4 in the World Conference Center, Bonn, WCCB. The press conference will be webcast live at https://unfcc-sb48.cloud.streamworld. To further highlights on the 29th of April, an Action for Climate Empowerment Youth Forum with people from around the world will take place. Initiated by Fiji at COP23 last year, the output from the forum will be presented to the negotiations of the operating manual for the Paris Agreement in an effort to strengthen education, awareness and public outreach under the agreement. On the 1st of May, the newly established Local Communities and Indigenous Peoples Platform will hold a workshop on how the tool can best boost local and indigenous contributions to climate action. On the 4th of May, a number of developing countries will showcase their climate actions in a new round of the so-called Facilitative Sharing of Views, FSV. Both achievements and unique challenges in mitigation action to date will be presented. On 7 and the 8th of May, a workshop will take place to help identify how to scale up climate finance for mitigation and adaptation in longer term. Throughout the two-week meeting, a series of gender-related events, including a gender dialogue on the 5th of May, have been scheduled to boost gender-responsive climate policy and to take forward the landmark 2017 Gender Action Plan. Copyright Scoop Media.